What is the CIO's role in innovation?
We typically see CIOs adopting three types of roles in innovation. The first and most common is that they retain their chief information officer title and they adopt an enabler role in the organization. So the assumption is that somebody else in the business, perhaps the chief marketing officer or research and development, is driving business innovation, and the chief information officer is enabling innovation through business processes. The second role that we see more and more is where the CIO becomes a chief digital officer. And there the CIO is using their knowledge of digital marketing channels, social media, and so on, to drive the ability of the business to market their products and services in new ways. And then finally, the most exciting thing that we're seeing is that CIOs are becoming chief innovation officers and are actually starting to drive the innovation agenda in the business, where they are putting processes for innovation in place not only in their own department, but also throughout the company, and are leading the charge towards turning usually a lot of product companies into service companies, which is happening more and more.
Well, organizations compete these days by being different, by being innovative. And technology is really the key to most innovation. And the CIO either needs to be a driving force, a participant in that discussion on innovation, or be left behind, because the organization is going to innovate regardless.
So if you know your organization wants to innovate, why? What are some of the triggers?
Well, the two main triggers that I see are growth and fear. On the growth side, what happens is that the economy's been booming and companies are now looking at a phase where they're really looking to grow revenue and generate growth. And this is difficult for the CIO, because the CIO has been used over the last 5 to 10 years of looking for cost reductions, and it's been focused on process efficiency and becoming more effective, and now is being asked to do a complete 180-degree turn and to start driving revenue growth. Traditionally, CIOs service departments like finance and HR and so on. Now they're being asked to link up with the sales and the marketing departments and support them. So that's very difficult, and that's the main trigger. There's another trigger that is fear, and that's fear of being disrupted. And sometimes we call this airline magazine syndrome, where the CEO will come rushing into the CIO's office and say, "Oh my God, we're being disrupted by Google or Apple. What are we going to do about this?" And now the CIO has to help generate a strategy to stave off disruption, and that often means cannibalizing the products and services that the company has been relying on for years by inventing new and different electronic and digital products.
So if the business is thinking about this need to innovate, are they often having those discussions and leaving the CIO out?
Unfortunately, very often the CIO gets left out of the discussions on innovation, primarily because the CIO is seen to be an obstruction to progress. The CIO is focused on control, is focused on compliance, is focused on security. These are all important things, but if they're in the forefront, they inhibit the role of the CIO as the idea generator, as the thinking out of the box individual.
Well, we have this diagnostic tool that we've run for the last couple of years called CIO Business Vision, where we ask a lot of the stakeholders of the CIO how satisfied they are with IT services. And we typically find that our CIOs and their IT departments fall into three different groups. One would be the firefighters, and I would say that they're not in a position to be at the table, and they're not generally invited to contribute to the innovation discussion because they haven't earned the credibility. Then we have a group called the trusted operators, where they have got their house in order, and they may or may not be asked to contribute to innovation because, again, they're being really trusted to operate the infrastructure of the IT organization, and they're not really known in the organization for innovation and contribution to the revenue, the top line of the company. The third group is the group that actually is doing innovation today, and that's about 23% of the respondents are in that innovation mode. So I would say that What you have is 23% of the group actually doing innovation, and that trusted operator group who have the opportunity and can aspire to become an innovator but have a lot of work to do to position themselves to contribute to the top line.
If product and service innovation is clearly a function of your research and development department, where does that leave the CIO?
Well, I think that although R&D very often gets involved in identifying products that need to be launched in the marketplace, the IT department is going to be responsible for operationalizing all of the support systems that need to be in place. So I'll give you an example. In the telecom industry, where I spent a number of years, there are all sorts of product ideas, but ultimately you have to build a client. And so the IT department had to be very much part of the planning of that billing system. So IT becomes a partner of the R&D group.
Well, it actually leaves the CIO in a very good spot, because in the 21st century, what we're seeing is that products are becoming services. And here I'll use a little case study. So, you know, in the brewery, the beer industry, traditionally research and development means developing new products, new beers, better tasting beers, beers that, you know, really have a consumer appeal. Now what's tending to happen is that beer is becoming immersed in services that, you know, go end to end. So for example, right now you can get some Internet of Things widgets to go in the kegs so that you can actually predict when a pub is about to run out of a particular brand of beer and have just-in-time delivery where that keg is delivered to the pub so they don't run out, the tap doesn't run out, and you actually preserve your product in the tap in the pub. So the CIO is the one who puts together all the back end back office systems and so on to ensure that end-to-end service that is more than just the beer itself.
If you want to go after innovation, what should you do tomorrow?
Well, at Infotech, we have an amazing blueprint on putting a 100-day plan together, and that's what I would advise. The 100-day plan gets you really going out of the gate in a hurry, and we talk a lot about putting quick hits together. And I think that's very consistent with the advice that we give in our innovation blueprint as well, where it says, you know, the best thing to do is to start innovating. Don't worry about the process at first. Just put small groups together, give them some problems to work on, and have them deliver some quick hits. And then start in the sort of the latter part of the 100-day plan, start thinking about formalizing that process and putting together the actual processes around innovation, the whole thing about prototyping and then doing business cases and stuff. But don't start there. Start by actually doing it and getting some results and delivering some credibility and getting the business to take notice of some of your successes.
If you want IT to be seen as an innovator, is there anything you should stop doing?
Well, one of the things that you have to be concerned about is the nature of the conversations that you have with people in kind of spontaneous, in the hall, over lunch type of conversations. And if you project the image of an innovator, of new ideas, and you're open to what's going on around you, what's going on in the industry, then you'll be perceived to be a useful contributor to that conversation. If, however, you go back to the traditional negative CIO no role that many of us play, then people won't want to have that conversation with you, and they'll have the conversation on innovation with those people who actually add to the discussion as opposed to hold it back.
If you're in a small enterprise, is your innovation plan going to look any different?
Well, there's some good news and there's some bad news, so let me start with the bad news. Small organizations tend to be much more restricted in terms of resources and in terms of time. And although they can be very innovative, they have to be quite selective about where they focus their energy.
That small enterprises already have a situation where the CIO is at the table. I mean, most small enterprises, the CIO is a very active participant in the management team and is already well respected and has an opinion on how to grow the company. In fact, the focus of most small companies is growth. So the CIO's head is already into the game. And that makes it a lot easier to gain credibility and help the management team come up with some innovative ideas. All you really need to do is to start honing in on the process of innovation and get better at that.